Now I'm having problems getting the flowers absolutely symmetric. So what I'm going to be doing is cutting into this and laying them out so that they are absolutely perfectly aligned. Now here I've marked out for perhaps the two center panels because I want it going in like a symmetric layout, and the pieces are not aligning absolutely perfectly. So we take the two center ones now. These are going to be easy enough to sew due to the fact that this the seaming is going to be done on parts which are not beaded, and that's actually a very good working out. So here, slightly, I'm going to do is lay that open. We're going to lay this panel on top of that, actually facing each other, so that we've got absolutely symmetric pieces. Now this, obviously this fabric has got a particular pattern that I'm having to actually cut to. If your fabric was one that you did not have to cut a particular pattern to. Okay, so this one is actually not coming symmetric with this. So what we're going to have to do is have two pieces. Now, what I'm going to do with this one is going to cut the armhole. And make this the one of the side panels. I'm going to add a bit of shape into this. And then slightly take it out as we go towards the bottom. Now we require another piece to be symmetrically laid on top of this to cut two perhaps further side panels. Thank you. So this is going to be the rough shape of the outfit, and then we'll have the panels inserted, sort of. Now these, I could actually use these two on the opposite side. I'm gonna have to work these out so that each of these panels goes symmetric. So each panel follows in line with the next. So that is actually correct, because each flower is going symmetric. So we have a choice of either I'm going to lay these on top of each other. Now the fabric, because of the fact that this is on a it's quite difficult to get it absolutely straight, due to the fact that this is against the grain, you tend to get more bias when it's against the grain than you do when it's swap this piece for that. So each of these pieces now has to be laid out and actually made sure that they are conforming to being absolutely correct. That's the kind of layout I want. So I'm going to take these pieces to a side. And one at a time, I'm going to try and correct these so that they're all equal and symmetric. This one is perfect. And with this, I want the two other side panels, which are these, I want these cut exactly the same. And they will be the four side panels. So first of all, get the bottom two equaled out. And then, making sure that we cut the right side, we're going to put these on top for the opposite side. these four pieces now, we want them absolutely evened out. And then the next four, we want those absolutely evened out. So take your time preparing these. This is the base for our whole garment, so we don't want any flaws in this, because if you have flaws in this, then your end result is going to get badly affected. So this is the one part that has heavy beads that we are going to have to get rid of, otherwise it's going to be impossible to sew. Well, apart from this, it's unfortunate that there are no beads in the areas that we will be sewing in. Now the other thing that we want, whilst we've got this all flattened out on the table, is the distance that we're going to be inserting the panels is 26 inches. So we measure 26 inches and these will be attached here, and we're going to make a notch at the point of 26 inches. Fold them, put them to a side, and then what we're going to do is lay out the rest of our pieces so that these are also symmetric. The first two are very nicely evenly done. I'm going to lay the other two on top. Now, if you want a heavy consolidated look, we could go for this kind of look, which makes the beading absolutely evened out on both the sides, which is probably what I'm going to go for. We're going to be inserting that. It's going to go on and actually So that's what the upper portion of, well, that's what the, without the pleats, this is what the actual outfit looks like. Okay, what I forgot to do was mark out whilst this was lying flat. I need to mark out where exactly are my pleats going to start from. So again, 26 inches on both the sides, and I will put in notches on both the sides at 26 inches. And this then leaves me a distance of 30 inches, which I require for my pleating. So the panels for the pleating, we're going to require 1, 2, 3 panels, so 6 panels. And each of the 6 panels are 22, so I want to do 24 inches. It's actually easier to cut this fabric, tear this fabric, than actually cutting this fabric. So what we're gonna do is mark it out and just do a straight tear. Now each of these pieces needs to be perhaps halved again. It's actually coming out marginally short. So what we're going to do is have to take I've made a mistake here because I should have taken out, well, mind you, I could take sleeves out from there. So just below the pattern here, I'm going to cut into this. And then cut the sleeves out of this one.